I get a lot of questions from students about the Hazen-Williams equation. The challenge is that there are so many different forms to the equation, and so students often make mistakes when they use a form but not the correct units for the input values. So I thought it would be helpful to make a video showing where each of the different forms derive from the original equation. It is important to note that Alan Hazen and Gardner-Williams created this equation after observing the velocity flowing through installed water pipelines ranging from 2 inches to 90 inches in diameter. Their goal was to provide an equation where the friction coefficient was easier to estimate than the Darcy friction factor. In this equation, roughness coefficient is a constant that is not a function of the Reynolds number. It is often scorned by researchers because the equation does not apply to other fluids, nor does it account for temperature variation. However, it is used extensively in the United States and is therefore an acceptable tool when analyzing water distribution networks and pipelines. The original empirical equation estimates the velocity equal to a conversion factor K times the roughness coefficient C times the hydraulic radius R to the 0.63 power times the friction slope to the 0.54 power. The conversion factor for U.S. common units is 1.318 and for metric units is 0.849. This equation is really only used in the U.S., so I'm not going to develop the equation for the metric approach unless I hear from someone in another country where you want to see that. Working with U.S. customs units, the velocity is in feet per second, the hydraulic radius is in feet, and the friction slope is unitless, but for our example, we'll assume it is in feet per feet. Despite the fact that this equation started off as a solution for fluid velocity, we rarely care about solving for velocity in a pipeline. What is really important is how much energy we are losing, which is accounted for in the friction slope term. To make this equation easier to use, we need to plug in all the constant values and also use the pipe diameter as one of the inputs. So we can bring in the 1.318 for K and D over 4 for the hydraulic radius. Typically, we have a design flow rate for the pipeline, Q. So instead of V, we substitute in Q over A, then substitute in pi D squared over 4 for the area. After a little math, we combine all the constants to get a version of the equation where we have the flow rate in cubic feet per second, the pipe diameter in feet, and the friction slope in feet per feet. Since the friction slope is essentially the head loss measured in feet divided by the length of pipe, we can separate that out and solve for the head loss in the pipeline. This provides us with our first useful stopping point. This equation will allow you to solve for the total head loss at any pipeline with the flow rate of Q in cubic feet per second and a pipe diameter of D measured in feet and the unitless roughness coefficient C. The head loss in this equation is the length times the quantity, open parentheses, 2.31 times Q divided by C times D to the 2.63 power, close parentheses, to the 1.85 power. To further make this equation easier to use, we need the flow rate to be in gallons per minute and the diameter in inches because those are the typical units used in water systems in the United States. Substituting those conversion values into our equation and then combining these constants once again provides us with a new equation where the conversion constant changes from 2.31 to 3.55. And that allows us to use the flow rate in GPM and the diameter inches. So essentially, you have the same equation as before, except the conversion constant is 3.55, and the flow rate that you input should be in gallons per minute, and the diameter that you input should be in inches. There are many water agencies across the U.S. that use Hazen-Williams equation to assess pipeline performance based upon the unit head loss. The unit head loss allows us to compare pipes of different diameters and flow rates based upon how much energy they are losing per 1,000 feet of pipe. To create the unit head loss version of this equation, we insert 1,000 for the pipe length and then do some math to bring it inside the parentheses, which gives us a new conversion constant of 148. Substituting this into the equation, we get the final version of open parentheses, 148 times Q divided by the roughness coefficient times D to the 2.63 power, close parentheses, to the 1.85 power. For instance, water agencies can say a pipeline in their system cannot have more than 10 feet per 1,000 feet of pipe. With this form of the equation, you can easily input your flow rate in gallons per minute and diameter in inches and check if it meets that criteria using this equation.